Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Marta and I'm so happy to have you here. It's been a while since I have uploaded my last English video, but I'm back. And I'm here to show you how I created this eye look. I share some tips and tricks on how you can easily recreate this. So I really hope this tutorial helps you and I hope you like this look. Before we get started, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and turn on the bell notification so you won't miss any of my videos. And don't forget to leave me a thumbs up if you do like this look. And now, let's get started. So first, I'm going to clean the bottom of my eyebrows using Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, and I'm using Anastasia's A4 flat brush for that. And if you want to see how I do my eyebrows, I'll leave a few videos that I have on my channel, a few tutorials. I'll leave those in the description box below. And I'm also going to be using this concealer as a primer for my eyeshadow, so I'm going to apply a little bit more on my eyelid and I'm going to blend it out with my finger. I do it in tapping motions and then just keep blending it out until everything is nice and even. Just one tone all over the eyelid, all the way up to my brow bone. And then before it dries up completely, I am going to set it using my Rimmel Stay Matte Pressed Powder and a fluffy brush from Profusion. I do it in tapping motions so the concealer doesn't move, so you won't see like the streaks of the brush. So first, set it in tapping motions and then I just take off the excess powder. And this is going to help a lot with blending out eyeshadows. It's gonna be a lot faster and easier, so I highly recommend this steps if you're a beginner. And you can also use a translucent powder or an eyeshadow that's the same shade as your skin tone. And today I'm going to be using this eyeshadow palette, Sienna's from Profusion. This is the first eyeshadow that I'm going to apply and I'm going to be using this brush. This one's from e.l.f. Cosmetics called Crease Brush. And I'm just going to apply this eyeshadow on my eyelid. I know it doesn't really make a big difference, like the color, it's like barely noticeable, but I wanted the lid to be a different color. Once it's on my eyelid, I'm going to grab a little more and then apply it on my crease and then just start blending it out. This is just to move the eyeshadow a little bit higher because I want it above the crease. And I'm just going to keep blending it out. But like I said, it's not a dark eyeshadow, so it's going to be really easy to blend out. Now I'm going to grab this eyeshadow right here and I'm using this brush from Anastasia A14, and you can see it does grab a good amount of product on the brush. And you can see that I have this eyeshadow above my crease, so I'm actually going to apply this eyeshadow looking straight forward into the camera. And I'm just going to go back and forth like this from the inner corner all the way to the outer corner. I'm going to make sure I don't apply it too low, like passing the outer corner. So it's just going to go from the inner corner to the outer corner, kind of like a rainbow. And then once I know I don't have that much product on the brush, or if you do have a lot of product on the brush, you can just take off the excess powder and then start blending out the edges. I like to do it in circular motions and I always use a light hand when I'm blending it out. So these steps have been really quick and easy to do. So the next step is what's a bit complicated, and that's the eyeliner. So for that, I'm going to grab this little brush. This one, I normally use this for my eyebrows. It's the Anastasia brush number 14. You can just grab any angled brush that's like this. I'm going to grab this eyeshadow right here. I'm going to start by creating a thin liner above the roots of my eyelashes, as close to the lash line as I can, from the inner corner all the way to the outer corner. Just like a simple liner. For the wing, I always pretend there's like a straight line from the outer corner of my eye to the tail of my eyebrow, and I just start by creating a line. Obviously, I don't go all the way up to the tail of my eyebrow, but I just like to pretend there's a line right there, which really helps me a lot. And I do this without having a lot of product on the brush. Now, to connect the eyeliner right here to the liner on my lash line, I never start from the very tip or like the tail of the wing. I always do it like the center part and then connect it to my lash line, and then I'm just gonna fill in the rest. Now I do want to extend the wing a little bit, so I'm not gonna grab any more product on the brush, just whatever's left on the brush, I'm gonna use that to kind of extend the tail or the winged eyeshadow. So I just do it very lightly. I literally barely touch my skin with the brush when I do this. One thing I like to do sometimes is I grab my brush. This one's the one I used to clean the bottom of my eyebrows. I didn't grab any more product, but it still has a little bit left from before. So I just used that to kind of clean the bottom of the wing eyeliner, which I don't really have to clean it because it looks really nice from the bottom, but I do want it to look a bit more sharp from the tip. So I just use this brush to kind of sharpen the wing. So I really like doing this because it makes it look very sharp and a lot better. I grabbed some of that same eyeshadow I used for the eyeliner with this little brush. This brush comes in the Rimmel eyeshadow palette, and I'm going to apply this on my lower lash line starting on the outer corner, and then I connect it with the eyeliner just right here, and then whatever's left on the brush I just blend it into the center and the inner part, and I just make sure it's nice and blended. Next, I'm gonna grab this shimmery eyeshadow using this little brush from e.l.f. Cosmetics. And this is for the inner corner highlight. I cannot not apply inner corner highlight. It's just, that's something I always do no matter what kind of look I'm going for. I don't know why I always, it just looks really nice, and to me it looks a lot better. It makes your eyes pop and I just really love it, and I feel like this gold shimmery eyeshadow looks really good. These eyelashes are from Isom Luxe Style Isom Luxe, and I feel like these are perfect. Just any eyelashes that are short from the inner corner and then longer towards the outer corner go perfect with an eyeliner look, because it just goes like, makes your eye look like lifted kind of like this along with the eyeliner. So these are really nice, a bit dramatic but really nice. And now I'm going to apply this mascara. This one's Maybelline Sky High mascara. I'm just going to apply one layer on my lower lashes. And that was the final step to complete this look. I really hope you guys liked it. Let me know in the comments below what you think and what you give this look on a scale of 1 to 10. I'd really love to know your thoughts on this look. And let me know in the comments below what other makeup tutorials you want to see, what colors you want me to use, or what kind of makeup you want me to do. Just anything, anything. Let me know in the comments below. And that is it for today's video. Thank you all so much for your love and your support. Thank you for sticking around. I love you all, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.